Greetings, friends. I am Gilles Mancillon. I thought I'd come to you briefly today to make a short message. I wanted to wish you a good day, to send you love and blessings as well. For today, we are still moving into this moment of integration that we're going to be coming into by the end of the year. I wanted to talk about the power of choice. For choice is essential. It is something that we all have as human beings. We don't have infinite choice. It is we have relative choice. But most of those choices, of course, everything I say is only my belief, the truth I perceive within situation that I try to. That I feel needs to be expressed in order to be shared so that it may be integrated by those who are open to those ideas. There are no absolute, there is no absolutes, but there are higher truths to be discovered. So the power of choice is essentially has been decided before we were born. Most of our choices, not decided for us, but we were born into, we were imprinted by celestial energy, the filters of perception, that was called astrology, and then we were born into a family, a social cultural environment that conditioned the potential of our life. So we have chosen this particular scene, circumstances, set of environments, so to speak, so that we may fulfill whatever mission we had planned from a soul level to accomplish. So no matter where we, some lives are more difficult, some lives are more easy, of course, but you cannot compare yourself to anyone else because your life is perfectly designed for you, and the day you understand yourself, you will understand the life of everybody else, for we are all one and the same in essence. But the real truth can only be discovered when you investigate your own self rather than of course everything is a mirror. So what I meant by wanted to say was that no matter what condition our life is, we all have potential to make it to always choose the highest choice. No matter what circumstance comes into to our life, sometimes we don't know the highest choice, but if we seek to do the most moral choice, the what's most ethical, what's most fair, what's more what brings the most joy, the most pleasure, the most satisfaction, not always instant gratification, but where there is the most potential for growth and evolution is what we need to choose always, and so we discover wisdom by doing that. The more we are able to align our will with the will of creation, for we all have this spirit within ourselves that is the pure spirit of God. But before we can discover that presence, we need to align our intention to the supreme love, to the supreme light, the highest frequency. And from there, the soul and the spirits are able to fuse and merge in and become one with the law. For the law is something that is not known yet by the human collective, this eternal law of God. And this law, in essence, is a supreme love. It is infinite perfection. It is a law that was created at the same time the universe was created to help, to assist every soul in its evolution. And so every thought, every word, every intention, every action that is not aligned with the supreme love, supreme wisdom, will be reflected back to us in a way that we can grow and evolve throughout countless time and incarnations. But there is no escape to that. We are involved in a path of evolution, and the way out is by making this most potent choice. I believe, to me, the most potent choice any human can make during a lifetime as a mortal being is to choose eternal life, to choose to believe that there is this higher will, this higher love, this higher wisdom, this higher state of existence, and seek to align with it in sharing that whatever we discover from within ourselves in that prospect of that process of discovery. So, in a sense, there is four things that There is four great principles in which we do not have a choice. We have absolutely no choice in that, but that is those are principles of existence that will be revealed to the mass consciousness when humanity will be ready. Those are not new principles. They've always been given to societies when they were ready to evolve into higher, more unified consciousness level of civilization. And so those four principles could be resumed in a simple way. The first principle would be the law of existence. I might have already talked about this, but I thought it was important to repeat it today. The law of existence means that you exist, you have no choice, you are included within life, there is nothing you can do to change that, and you have to accept the fact that you exist, that you are part of creation, that you are an integral part of creation, you are a unique part of creation too, so nobody can replace you in that creation that is the universe of universes. You are a unique being, and so you have to realize, to accept that as a creation your existence is essential and fundamental, and if you were not loved by the universe, by the source, you would not even exist. It wouldn't be possible. Nobody could do anything. There would be no life force. So if you have a life force within you, that means you are a creation, and you are, and it is unavoidable to recognize, to accept, to enjoy your existence. And the second principle is tied into the second principle, which states that all is one and one is all. For the source, I hesitate to use the term God because people fantasize with religious concepts, but the source, the creator principle, the supreme intelligence that is at the core of all manifestation, has created all living beings with sentient status, such as mortal beings, with the possibility of aligning with this higher will. And once this is done, there is a unification that happens. And so, in essence, God has created us equal to Himself. That means we are just as potentially sovereign of our own realities, just as God is sovereign over the whole universe of universes. So that means that one is all and all is one. Everything is connected. There is every other being is just an extension of you. All this amazing universe is just an extension of your consciousness, of your soul. But in essence, if it wasn't part of you, you could not even perceive it. So those separation it's part of the process, the game of duality, to create those separation. But the point is to dissolve the veil, to create a better unity, create a consciousness of unity in our life, so that we may feel more love and connection. The third principle is the law of karma, the law of cause and effect, the law of the circle, which means that everything we produce, we're going to have to harvest. Everything we send out, we're going to have to get back. Everything goes in circles. So eventually we want to get rid of any action, any words that could hurt anyone, because otherwise it's a matter of self-protection. And to be benevolent toward life is actually, it may sound selfish, but it's a way to protect yourself against karma. And the more you are able to do good things, it helps also to clear up a lot of karma. Sometimes, because if someone does something really, really dysfunctional during his whole lifetime, then the next lifetime he comes into a very, very, very difficult life. And then we say, oh, the poor guy is a poor person. But in essence, he's learning the lesson that he needs to learn, or everybody is learning the lessons that we need to learn. We choose those incarnations consciously in order to learn the lesson that we need. And so there is really no need to compare to one another, just improve your own quality of life. And by doing that, you increase the life of everyone around you as well, by your higher frequency. So in essence, to say that all is one and one is all, it's given the law of karma and magnetic attraction, everything is always felt from after this life. We are able to feel life in essence of all the actions that we have done are being reflected to us in a conscious way, so that we can integrate everything we've done in each incarnation before we choose another one that will teach us the lesson that we need to learn. But in essence, once you reconnect during one lifetime to your eternal nature, there is no more need for incarnation, there is no more need for karma. But where you expurge it throughout this life. But there is once the understanding is gained, there is no point on keeping you in this duality frequency, for you will naturally ascend into a higher light and whenever the time is appropriate. And for that, this great divine minister is as well as your guardian angel will definitely make that happening when it's the time. So in essence, the third principle is the law of cause and effect. So everything in a magnetic universe, we are vibrational beings. So the higher our vibration, the more we will attract higher vibration thought, idea, situation, and so on. And the fourth principle would be, for those who are more atheists, would be everything is in perpetual change, except the first three laws. For those who are understanding the concept of divinity, we would say that everything is in perpetual change, transformation and change, except God, that is changeless, for God has never changed. Before the universe was created, the Paradise Trinity was the Paradise Trinity. The universe is now created, there hasn't been any change whatsoever in those beings. And I assume that even if the cosmos would grow eventually, towards the infinity of space, that will never change the power of the gods to englobe this magnificent creation. So in essence, to say that everything we experience is just temporary, but the essence of who we are does not change. If we associate ourselves with divinity, we are the essence of divine love. And so it is important to meditate on those laws. Let's try to integrate them, because they will definitely simplify our life once we are able to fully embrace them. I wanted to pull out a card today. Today the card is breakthrough. So let us break through. It is a time to come out, to break through, to something new is ready to happen. So let it happen. Enjoy your day. Hopefully be playful, be joyous, be light. Do not take the problems of life too seriously, and flow over those things that are discordant, so that you may land into a place where it's more aligned with what your soul really wants. For the soul is love, and it's just the ego that has that has taken control over the body, and so it's programmed and with all kinds of conditioning, and so they have to be slowly but surely, with a lot of patience, to deprogram, to reprogram some new ways of perceiving things. But these new energies that are coming in 2017 will definitely create a great improvement in our sensitivity, in our ability to perceive beyond the third dimension, to look into things with a more refined, more sophisticated, more delicate, more accurate, far more elegant sort of perception. For the higher dimension is far more gracious, for we came down from that higher dimension, from the world of pure light and spirit, and we came down into the impure world of the earth with the mission to study, but eventually we need to return to the light, to the world of purity, and we do not need to be perfect to achieve that. We just need to be in acceptance of all that is, and from there we will be able to be guided to whatever next step we need to take. Well, I hope this message was interesting for you. I thank you very much for your support, for subscribing, for sharing, for liking, for all your comments. Everything, it's kind of nice for me to know that those messages are being received, and I will continue to do so. I'm looking forward to seeing you in my next video, and I wish you a wonderful day. Namaste.